everyone wanted to talk about how to effectively re-rack that barbell from that overhead position back to our shoulders without killing ourselves and without using too much energy on the way down, so we're able to kind of let that bar free fall onto our shoulders instead of letting it kind of muscle it down the entire way. So instead of looking like something like this from overhead, where we're kind of slowly pulling that barbell down to this position, then having to re-pump it back onto our shoulders, we're looking to kind of bring it from the top here, letting it crash back down onto our chest while maintaining that energy, maybe even into the next rep, or just so we're not using so much energy with our arms on the way down. So the first thing we want to do with that barbell directly overhead here is we're going to lower it about 2 or so inches just with our arms alone. We can even dip down a little bit too if it helps. Dipping down a little bit, lowering that bar with our arms the first little bit of distance. After this, we're going to want to get onto our toes while we're still lowering that bar down to shorten the distance the bar has to travel from overhead to our chest. So as we're on our toes here, we're continually letting that bar down. As it gets about past our face or so, we're looking at the bar, we're gonna re-dip with that bar to soften the impact that it has as it lands on our chest here. And then standing back up with it. Some things to know with this one is we wanna keep that nice, sturdy front rack position here when we come down with it. We don't wanna let everything kind of crumble forward. So we're pushing our shoulders, or not our shoulders, our elbows out in front of us, maintaining that nice, solid rack position. From the side, it'll look something kind of like this. So we're overhead, letting that bar come down the first 2 or so inches onto our toes to shorten the distance. As it gets past our face, we're looking to catch that bar in a little bit of a quarter spot, squat or so, just to sort of lessen the blow on our shoulders, and then standing right back up. Big thing here between letting that bar just kind of ride down onto our shoulders and sort of dynamically catching into this position is getting onto our toes. We'll see when we're flat-footed here, we have no ability to shorten that distance. That bar has to travel from directly overhead to your shoulders in the entire distance on its own. When we get onto our toes here, as we're lowering it, we're able to meet that barbell and then let it ride down the rest of the way onto our shoulders. It's really going to be effective when we see Metcons with quite a bit of shoulder to overhead movements. We're able to kind of transform that energy from the way up, down here, even into the next rep. Instead of having to get from overhead, repositioning ourselves back down, we're able to use that energy that we create when we bring that bar down and push it up right into the next rep. So take a look at a slow-mo here where we can actually see our feet in action on like that last little clip. We can see as that bar comes down, we are indeed lowering our body as well as our arms the first couple of inches or so. After that, we are extending with our body, getting onto our toes to shorten that distance between the barbell and our chest. And as that bar gets past our face, we're re-dipping, letting that bar soften onto our shoulders instead of letting it crash on there. And then even from that bottom dip position, we're able to either stand back up with the barbell if that's the end of the rep, or we're able to use that energy from the dip and put it right back over.